people that don't understand why we pray. I'm not talking to a people that don't know what happens when we call on the name of Jesus. But I'm talking to just two or three people that understand things happen when we call on God's name. And people that understand demons tremble at the name of Jesus. Demons become subject at the name of Jesus. Demons are cast out at the name of Jesus. Oh,
Thank you. How how to keep me and et cetera, they said, but the message kind of made me realize it's just your character. It has nothing to do with a lot of outside, exterior things that we judge people by, and we look at people and we try to put in a box, but it really is our character, because God is a God of honor. Say amen. Amen. And so I want to stay here, and as I said, I'm going to try not to be before you long, and what I pray to do is be able to bring to our front, and these are some things that we know, but sometimes it's always good to be refreshed. Because as you are going through your daily life, and as you're going about your hustle and bustle of life, as I say so often, saints, you can't ever underestimate what level of spirituality you walk in. You can't underestimate that maybe I'm not doing this or that in ministry, so it must not mean that I'm anointed. That's a lie from the pit of hell. Because you are a child of the King. You are a bright light by yourself. I need some praise right there. And being that light makes you have a target, and I hate to say it that way, but it's true. The Bible said that we are as sheep for the slaughter every single day. There's a mark in our life that you can't ever underestimate, that Satan sees that light in you, and Satan is covetous of that light because he once had it and will never get it again. So Satan's ambition and his desire is to bring defame humanity, to cause us to do things what God have not created us for, to cause us to come out of character and to make this temple dishonorable. And so it's necessary to teach on the things that are honorable to God, because we're constantly learning how to present our bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and
acceptable.
Holy and
acceptable.
Which is our... So it's not like it's something unique. It's not like it's something you're doing as a favor. It is something that you're saying, this is what I do, because I realize I am the temple of God, and I realize that he dwells with me and he talks with me. And it's no comparison of how much a person speaks in tongues over another person. It's the fact when I believed in him and he came into my house, he now dwells with me. And so he dwells with my conscience, and he checks my conscience, and he dwells with my spirit. And even though sometimes I used to have this happen often when I was a younger girl, and as I was getting filled with the Holy Spirit and trying to learn his voice, there were things that the Lord would say to me that later I would find out it was a scripture. Now, I may not have quoted exactly that, but then you'll find out, oh my God, I didn't know that was actually in the Bible, but he was dealing with my conscious man. Are y'all working with me? Because that's how he does. He walks with us. He talks with us. His job is to lead and guide us into all truth. The Holy Spirit will never lie to you. It cannot lie. It cannot lie. And the more that we give ourselves over to God, the more we get keen to what's his voice from the words of Satan, because there's always influence. There's influence everywhere we go. Everything you do, there's influence. And so with that, Lord, help me today, with that, that becomes the spiritual warfare that you tackle every single day and not knowing it. There are thoughts that are in the spirit realm that you don't even know. There's issues, and there's people, demons, that they bring to your job, and they're sitting next to you, and you're all around it, and you're thinking, what is this? This is not me exactly, but this is called spiritual wickedness in high places. But when I understand my vessel and God's, how do I present myself in honor, then that helps separate. It's almost like it blows the world away. It's like it blows it all away, because I'm clear what the Father have asked me to do that's honorable unto him. I cannot emphasize how bold this world is today, and how they're bold in their lifestyles, and they're bold in their choices, and they're bold in telling government what they think. They're so bold, and yet we're not seeing enough boldness as believers to stand up and be what God asks you to be. I need some praise up in this house. I tell you often, and I hope you can understand what I'm saying, I'm taking full advantage of having an outspoken president. Some of you just say amen, so I'm good. I am taking full advantage that if my president could say anything on his mind, I wish I might quit scriptures and be ashamed to tell you what's on my mind. I would tell people I learned it from my president. It's making me bolder to be able to speak what I feel in my heart about Jesus. It's making me bolder to express why I do what I do. I was in Starbucks the other day, and there was this a more mature woman, like a person ahead of us, and then there was this other young lady between us. And so the lady turned around, she said, "Good morning." I said, "Good morning." And she said, "I love the Lord." I said, "Me too." And she said, "I love him with all of my heart." girl in between was like, it felt so good. Like, trap through the end. We can talk about Jesus. I need some prayer up in this house. It feels good. And that's what God is calling. That becomes the peculiarness and the boldness, is because we're walking in the honor of our Father. With no shame, our heads are not held down. We don't have to explain nothing to you. I tell people often that belief is something that must come from you.
Amen.
The Bible said faith coming by
hearing,
and hearing by
word.
But you ain't got to believe the words you just heard.
Right.
Belief comes from you. How many times have you been in a discussion with a person and it can maybe be about the word or anything, and you know what they'll say? I don't believe that. And when they say that, that means that word cannot take root.
Right.
That means that word immediately disseminated in the air because it did not take root. And so everything that God is doing and where he's shifting the church is he's shifting us, because church, it is as he is coming.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
As he is coming, he's setting the foundation and the platform for his glory to be revealed.
Yes.
He's setting a foundation. He's clearing a path so his glory can be revealed. His glory is not revealed in the sky.
Come on.
Jesus, his glory is revealed in us. And he longs to dwell in our temples. He longs to manifest and sup with us in our temple. And so he's laying a foundation, because, church, we cannot continue to make excuses for sin. But we have to genuinely present our bodies, because we understand this temple is where his glory is supposed to abide. I need some praise up in this house. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. So here we are with honor. Next slide. I know I have a clicker. Back up. Honor. Here we go, because we got to get this. Honor is the honesty. It's fairness. It's integrity in what you believe. It's your actions. And so because within the body of Christ at large, there's so much dishonor, what it's causing is causing people to not believe God is real.
Yeah, come on.
Unbelief is rapid, not because of God.
Yeah.
It's because I can't see him. And they're not going to see him in the naked eye. But I need to see he exists somewhere. He's not going to exist in a dog or a cat. He exists in us. So honor begins to teach us by the word. We learn how to bring our members subject into integrity. This is not self-righteous. That's when people go off. I do it because I love my Father. Tripping over it, don't stop you from dishonoring God and gapping your legs. expectation of who I know I am and what God has said. I don't want that in your life.
Hallelujah.
It is distinct. It is a demeanor about you. It's an air about you that when everybody else is doing things on the job, you refuse to.
Right.
You keep yourself honorable. It's just, that's my thing. So when they try to question you, and when you don't laugh at their jokes, and when you don't get with their cussing, y'all talk back to me.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
Ain't that, I don't think what you said, but I speak English.
Right.
And I found that to be a very proper way of telling a person that I'll take all your cussing. Girl, and that ended up, and I told that so-and-so, and you said, I'm sorry, can you say that again in English?
Right.
Y'all look like Pastor be doing too well. I'm just saying. Because what you tell them is don't bring me that. Y'all better talk back to them. You better act like you know them demon words will follow you when you get through talking to them. Y'all better act like them demon words will. I'm sorry. I need to delete that. Can you say that again in English? Now, let me tell you, if you say that one or two times, guess what they're going to stop doing? Cussing around. Talk to me in English. I only know English. And he said, high respect. As for worth or merit, ranking. That's what honor does. Here we go, next slide. So then salvation, I want us to remember this, becomes the process of bringing individuals into honor, which results in honorable marriages, honorable finances, honorable lifestyles. When you begin to bring your life in honor, then it begins to shape everything about you. You will find choices to be different when you start bringing your life in honor. I promise you, you'll start seeing life differently when you bring yourself into honor. And as you bring yourself into honor, you begin to break generational curses.
Amen.
This is why we submit to it, because I need to know. I know the street way. I know, again, conversation with some daughters, and they were saying how they ended up in certain relationships. And he said, Pastor, it was just the way things were in the community. And this was like the law of the community of who you slept with and what you did things with until I heard about a thing called a virtuous woman. And they said it blew my mind because I just knew what to do from the community. Y'all talk back to me. And that it was just normal. That's what the word does. And the word defies any street teacher.
Right.
The word defies all family myths and curses. Honor. And the word, shout hallelujah. And the word begins to align your life. And bring your life into your true purpose. Just because we come from the same mother and father doesn't mean we'll have the same purpose with God.
Amen.
Because for God, we're seen individually. So just because you were raised in the same thing, let me tell you this. Just because you was raised in the same church don't mean you're going to have the same purpose. And it doesn't guarantee that God's hand is on you for the good. That's why he said, if you hear my voice, he said, stranger, they won't follow. They'll hear my voice and you'll continue to bring yourself into honor. I want to talk about honor today, and I want to talk about honor in finances. And some of this we're going to already know, but I want to refresh us so we can understand why we do what we do.
Amen.
And not only refresh us, but I want to educate people because there are some things that people have as myths about church and about giving, and really what it's doing is it keep pushing you out of dishonor. Watch this. And that's people that's even here and can still speak in tongues.
Yeah. Yeah.
But don't believe what the word says about honor in finances. I need y'all to talk back to me. Not everybody, but you will. Here we go. So let's go to the word. Let's go to Proverbs 3. I think I want Proverbs 3 and 9. I want to start there. Proverbs 3 and 9. Proverbs 3 and 9 in the world. Oh, thank you, Lord. Our Bible said, honor, having Income And if he help you get money back, you don't lose by giving him a blessing back.
You're going
in it and lotion and soap, all this kind of stuff. But then when you go there,
right,
you're looking up in their tents and you're looking at their shoes with holes in, you say to yourself, it's not enough.
Right.
So then some of the saints are saying that they're right and they're true. You know, Pastor, there's grants from Walmart. And I said, no more. No more. No, I said, now if some team on their own, because you can't do it, want to go after grant money for Walmart and all that, then God bless you, we're going to use it. But I said, no, we are raising a house that we got this. I don't need no grant. I see 100 people get $100. We got this. Because we got the overflow. I need some work. Abraham as his blessing. And that became the order of the church. keep it moving. Acts 5 and 1, and I'll just do the King James version of this. Acts 5 and 1. So by the New Testament, they were building the church. And they, while tithing, and let me back up a little bit, because there's a lot of theological discussions whether tithing was still right, how were the people giving. And this passage can kind of give an answer to that, but I want us to understand what happened. And again, many of us may know the story, but I hope I can either refresh you or educate you. So a certain man named Ananias with his wife Sapphira, they sold some land. And they kept back part of the price. And his wife, being privy to it, the two of them got together, and they said, we know we sold the land for this, but this is how much we're going to give. So they brought a certain part and laid it at the apostles' feet. But Peter said to Ananias, why had Satan fill thine heart to lie to who, everybody?
The Holy Ghost.
You're not lying to me. Wow. He just revealed to me that you're not telling the truth. But you're coming like everybody is coming and presenting their seed or their best offering to the church. Back up a little bit. Malachi, when he said, pay your tithe, give your tithe for office so that there's meat in my house, I want the church to understand. So everybody is strategically blessed at levels that God knows when they do what they need to do in this house, there will be no lack of meat. Y'all hear what I'm saying? So he strategically will call you here. He will strategically bless you with the job, making that amount of money. Y'all better hear me. Because he already knows if everybody do their part, then there will be no lack of nothing in the house. Talk back to me. Pastor Bennett does not know your household income. And I'm not going to ask you. Ask me why. Don't ask me why. Church.
Right.
He said, as I This is the demon that messed people up. God does not need your money.
Right.
And I want us to understand honor. Trust me, I'm going by a witness. He does not need your money. And when we don't do what we're supposed to do, you're always going to have a remnant that's going to do what God told them to do, and he will double their blessing to make up for what you didn't. She gets church. Not knowing what happened, she came. blessed at first. Peter asked her, so I'm going to give you a chance. So let me make sure I understand this. Y'all sold y'all land. This is how much you made for it, right? Yep. That's right. Thank you, brother. This is where I got to throw this out there.
Yes.
Wives.
Right.
Obey your husbands in the Lord.
Amen.
They tell you to do something out of the Lord. You're not.
Amen.
Now, does that make sense, honey, for both of us to die? Come on, baby.
Right?
Come on, sweetie. Does it really make sense? Should we both be cursed? We have children. She said, yep. That's what he said. Standing by my man. He said, uh-huh.
All right.
It's verse. He said to her, help me understand how you let the devil tempt you the same way he tempted your husband. Two is better than one. Because if the one fall, the other should lift them up.
Yeah.
I know about finances and marriage. We're married. And there's going to be times you're going to agree. You will always discuss where the money going to go. Married people say amen.
Amen.
Somebody wanted to go here, some may wanted to go here. Argue as long as you want about going to Home Depot. We only go pay this much. Okay, no, don't pay this much. You get in that refrigerator, we only pay this much. Argue with that all you want. Going to go get this car. I'm not going over $500 car. All right, all right. But when it comes to the house of God, don't you negotiate that.
Amen.
And somebody got to be showing us that, babe, we got to do this right. Doctor, you cannot lie to the Lord. That's when you can open up your blessing, is when the two become one. And I know this is sensitive right now because I can feel it. But sure, I'm giving you the New Testament, not the old. He did not curse them over the dollar.
Yeah.
It was that y'all came together to lie to the Holy Ghost.
Right.
And nobody's going to go in your business. But watch the blessing leave that home. Watch the cloud that's going to dwell in that home. I'm telling you what I know. I'm telling you what I know.
Yeah.
When you don't do what's right and honoring God with your finances, and here's the thing, here's the truth. If you never did it, if you never started honoring Him, then you didn't see the benefit yet. But if you ever start honoring God with your finances, if you ever start being right, that's when you say, oh, we can't play with that. And you're going to pay our tithes. People that are right for a week, so I get my next trip. Now, let's go to Proverbs. Tracy, I'm really sorry you got to help me out because I have no idea where this is. You know, I hate the weekend and all, you know, this is best. Why are you letting everything on the bill? Because he's evil. That's why I blame everything on him. Proverbs 11:24, everything wrong, I blame you on him. I got to hang you on that devil. Everything evil, I do, I blame you on him. Your hair falling out, the devil. Proverbs 11:24. Okay, let's go. Let's go to, hold on, okay, let's keep that. So the Bible said, freely you have received, and freely you give. That's not saying be naive, be a volunteer user and you let people use you. That's not what that's saying. Because remember, he blessed me to be a blessing to my family. And so that my needs are met. And everything that I touch is going to prosper because of how he's blessed me. But understanding that my blessing that God put on me is for the overflow of those that are listening. So freely I've received, and freely you give. The Lord is laying a foundation in this house. And that's why that song today just took me off, just took me here. Because it's layers of dismissing worldly ways and dishonorable ways. And when I tell you it's warfare, it's warfare.
Right.
Because you're plowing out dishonor. You're plowing out habits. You're plowing out lifestyles that have brought dishonor in your temple. And now you're trying to lay a new foundation. Hallelujah. Which you might not see results immediately, but your consistency, because his word can't lie. You know it's coming back with a blessing. Everyone say to me, say to me. Thank you, Lord. So I wanted to just clear us to understand these next levels of honor. And what we're going to strive to do is bring honor in every area of our life. That's where we're going. It's bringing honor in every area of our life. There's something I'm praying about, and I haven't released it yet, but I'm praying on it. All of honor started in the Bible with the men of God.
Amen.
All of honor started with Abraham. He said, Abraham, everything you curse, I will curse. This is the honor I'm giving unto you. Everything you bless, I will bless. There is an elevation he's doing to the men of God, not only in this house, but throughout the nation, his men of God. And God is dismissing lifestyles that Satan drew us in that brought dishonor.
Right.
I truly believe with all of my heart that we will grow to a place that we will see men walk out of prison and walk into honorable lives. Because the gospel of Jesus Christ must be preached. We're striving to raise an army that get it. We get who we are. We accept who we are. We embrace who we are. No shame, no apologies, no explanations. We are a chosen people. Hallelujah. We are a royal priesthood. Hallelujah. And when people ask, how did you get what you get? I honor God.
Hallelujah.
How did you accomplish what you accomplished? I just honor God. How did you get it? I just try to honor God. And you keep that blessing, church. You keep that blessing. The same way you got that blessing. You stay in that order to keep that blessing. Don't ever get so arrogant. Don't ever get so cocky. Don't you ever look down on somebody else.
Yeah.
The same way it took for you to get that blessing,
right.
It's going to take that to keep that blessing. Thanks be to the Lord. We want to make things right. And I don't want Ananias and Sapphira's spirit in this house.
Right.
We want to make it right. Nobody's judging nobody. Nobody, because it's not our business. What we have to do was honorable to God. And when I read that story again in Ananias, it said all he had to do was repent.
Yeah.
Lord, I'm sorry. We will challenge scriptures. We will challenge messages. And all we have to do sometimes is just repent. When the word finds you, don't try to fix you. God is talking to your inner man of where he's taking you. Don't fix it. Just repent. I need to make things right. Because I need the windows of heaven to be open. I want to know my purpose. Let me tell you something. The Bible said, money answers. Money answers. Money answers. You show me a broke man, and I'm going to show you a mean man after a while. You know why? Because you were made to rule. You were made to lead. And so men of God, if that household is going to shift, it's got to shift by you first. You do what's honorable. Because God hears you. I'm not telling the sisters God don't hear you too. But I got to talk to our sons. He's calling you because the strength lies with you. The anointing is with you. And if we're going to shift some things, brothers, your head is held down because you ain't got enough money. You ain't got enough money because God can't give it to you. He just wants you to do what's right by the mouth he gives you now.
Right.
So instead of waiting for the bigger, bless what you got right now and watch the increase. Give me some praise. Bless him with what you got right now. Honor him. Honor him and watch the increase. Watch the increase. I anticipate, and I've been saying it and speaking it, I anticipate in the next 5 to 10 years that we will have millionaires raised up in this country. I anticipate in the next 5 to 10 it will be a normal, no big thing, just no big thing. Because we learn to apply iron. Has nothing, you need to come to this altar, I need you to come now. It's just you, it's just you, it's just you, it's just you, it ain't nobody else, it's just you. It's just you. It's just you. It ain't got to do with nobody else. It's just you. It has nothing to do with anybody else but you. I want to tell my dear sisters, that struggle could come out of your house by giving. This is about you. Nobody else. This is about you and nobody else. Listen to me. The struggle will come out of your house by giving. The struggle will come out of your house by giving. The struggle will dismiss your house. Jobs and opportunities will open up just by you honoring God. I just need praise to go up in this house because we're shifting this. We're shifting it. We're shifting this. We're shifting this. We're shifting this. We're shifting this. We will be honorable men and women of God. We will be honorable all the way around. All the way around. All the way around. We're honorable in our things. It's time for things to shift. There are opportunities never are not available. There are always opportunities available. And God will open up the one for you because you honored him. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. The men and women of God that's coming. The men and women of God. Those that are saying, I need to honor the Lord with my body. I need to honor the Lord. I need to bring some things. You're coming. You're coming because this is you talking to God. This is about you. This is about you. I'm bringing some things in honor. I'm bringing some things in discipline. This is about you. And as you bring that honor to the Lord, that's your vessel. That's your vessel. I want you to hear me, church. It is not the will of God that we struggle. That is not his will. It is not his will that we have great life. That is not his will. He has opened up and given us the channels. How you honor me, and watch me open up the blessing. Hands are lifted before the Lord. I need some ministers to pray with the souls at the altar. I need ministers quickly comforting the souls at the altar. As we're at this altar and you're talking to God and God is talking to you, you're to tell them, forgive me. Period. Just forgive me for dishonoring you. I want to thank you, Lord, for blessing me. Thank you, Lord, for seeing about my needs. We got to tell the Lord, forgive us for complaining. Forgive us for murmuring. But Father, I ask that you release that honor in my life. Release it. Release it, Father. Release the spirit of giving out of my heart. Release the spirit of giving that I may bring the blessing unto you. I need praises. They're still coming. I need praises. They're still coming. I need praises. They're still coming. It is my honor to honor you, Father, as I give my life and my heart. I'm giving you my heart. I'm giving you my heart. I'm giving you my heart. And whatever this is that has hindered me from honoring you, Lord, I want that out of my heart. I need some intercessors and prayer warriors to come. I need every one of these souls to be praying with. I need more intercessors and prayer warriors to come. I need every one of these souls to be praying with. So, Father, I submit to you. The ways I've dishonored you, I want you to forgive me. Ways that I did not honor you, I want you to forgive me. I'm bringing it all. I'm bringing it all because I need you to work for me. Here we go. Here we go. They're coming. They're coming. I give you all.
I pour my soul till I'm empty. I pour my soul till I'm empty. I pour my soul till I'm empty. Fill me.
I give you the best of me.
Let's give Brenda the honor of the Lord. This is above your tithes. $100 seed above and beyond your tithing. And what we're going to do is we're going to watch God begin to open up some supernatural doors financially. And we're not weary and well doing because we're going to reap if we just don't faint. 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 Don't get weary and well doing, for you just have need of patience. And after you've done the will of God, wait on the promise. Just wait on the promise. I have concluded I need more patience. I have concluded I want instant results. And it ain't gonna happen that way all the time. But you stay consistent. Stay consistent. Because God said it. He said, you just got to need a patience. I got this. Hallelujah. And what I'm forming in you of honor is for a lifetime. It ain't for the summer. It's for the rest of your life. I need some praise in this house. I made foundations of honor, and this is who you are for the rest of your life. These are the codes you live by. These are the principles that guide you. So for all of those that are family members, and this is Pentecost, and if you do not have a church home, I invite you to be a part of our home. We're not the best church in town, but we are a church in town that love Jesus and that are chasing after Jesus. It's not a perfect church, but there's not a perfect world because there's no perfect people. Quote I used to do all the time, and I know you might be drunk, but if you could look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, there is a perfect church. Okay, look at your neighbor again. Neighbor, there is no perfect church. Ask them why. Because you win. Ain't no perfect church. Ain't no perfect church. Ain't no perfect people. But we're chasing a perfect God. Hallelujah. Who's got perfect love for all of us. Who's got a perfect grace for all of us. Who's got perfect mercy for all of us. Who's got perfect long suffering for all of us. And we're learning how to do that together. So tithers are preparing themselves. Tithers are preparing themselves. Tithers are preparing their speed. Tithers are preparing themselves. Givers are preparing themselves. He is absolutely releasing a spirit of giving in this house. Shout hallelujah. It is absolutely. That is that next level that you are most comfortable in giving. You feel good when you give. That's your gift. That's your gift. It is the gift of giving that you feel good when you have it. You feel depressed almost when you don't have it to give, when you can't be a part of the need. And when you have a spirit of giving, it flows in everything. It's not just money. When you're a giver, it's just in everything you do. It's in working. It's in labor. It just becomes who you are. And you understand it. So we're building this honor. We're building honor in our finances. I don't do this often, but I highly recommend those of you that are serious about bringing your finances into honor and bringing your finances into order, I highly recommend that you take one of Sister Vivian's financial classes. Hey, those that have taken over, testify. I highly recommend that you see, where's the Vivian? She was, Vivian, can you stand? Stand. Those of you that don't know this powerful financial guru, from getting your credit, setting a budget in your household, she's not a busybody, she's not a talker. I don't know what goes on in the classes, things remain confidential. And she tries to teach things on a high level, but if you want a one-on-one, she'll do that. But when it comes to knowing the game of credit, how to get your credit score up. I ain't gonna call out people, but Debra, you got a nice credit score now, don't you? I ain't gonna say what it was before, but. But you get Mr. Tarot got it. Woo! Tarot got a blessed credit score. Y'all see his Lexus, he drive. I'm just saying, these are people I know personally. We prayed and we prayed. And finally, they had to go to Sister Vivian and learn how to do it. Because we found out prayer wasn't enough. You had to get wisdom. You got to get wisdom. Prayer is not going to change your credit score.
Okay.
I've believe in miracles too. But you want wisdom. So that even if a miracle happened, you get an 840 credit score. You got wisdom how to keep it. So it's wisdom. So if you do not, it's her, it's something God put in our heart to do that have helped many, many people align themselves with their finances. And she used biblical principles and natural principles. So I'm saying that to say, because we're learning how to honor God. And parents, if we're not, as you learn, parents, you have to sit down with your children and teach your children money. You have to teach your children money. You just can't let them just have money and blow it and spend it. You got to teach your children money because we're breaking curses. Amen? Amen? We're breaking curses and we're teaching them how to honor God with their money. And as I said, that honor becomes in everything. When I'm just, you become just in everything. You pay your bills. You make arrangements with creditors. You don't let it just go off the fly. You do what you best. And again, I ain't got time to tell you my crazy testimonies of how God wiped credit out for me and made things, doors open because I tried to be right and honor the Lord in my giving first. And then I learned how to pay bills on time and giving them a little something, something, just to let them know I'm serious. And God begins to open the door. When he taught me about tithing, and when I began to obey him in tithing, which was around 1994, but it really, the spirit of giving kicked off in 96. I have never struggled since 1996. Never. I have never been broke. Trying to do what's right by God and then let him do what's right. Because if you honor him, he will.
Honor you.
Speaking of honor, let's stand to our feet. Those tithers, any tithers and givers to stand. Tithers and givers to standing. And we're honoring the Lord. We're honoring the Lord. Who are we honoring?
The Lord.
Who are we honoring?
The Lord.
We're honoring the Lord. And he knows and he sees. And that's why he makes the blessings come back to your house. He sees. He knows your need, church. Relax. Relax. God knows your need. Relax. He sees your bills. He knows your need. And he's a God that will supply your every
need.
So relax. He sees it and he knows it. So every time you give, he knows that you're giving towards what it is that you desire from the Lord. And he's going to supply that. I promise you, church, he will make bill collects all of a sudden. This month only, 75% of your credit thing. So your bill that was $1,000, if you just give us $200, we'll wipe it off. It's not. I need y'all to call back. That's how it works.
Right.
I've had $1,800 things that you needed to pay. And they said, well, how much you got? And I'm being funny. Seriously, it was like $250. Well, we'll accept $275. Yes. I'm telling you the truth. That's how it works.
Amen.
When you begin to do what's right by God, God will make man work in your favor. I need two witnesses. Enjoy that to the three. All right. Those of us that are sowing our tithes and our offering, those of us that are sowing, I need a hand right now. Put everything down. Those of us that are sowing $100 above our tithes and our offering, I need you to raise your hand. I need to see that we got it. I need to see we got it. We're asking for 100 people that can sow $100 above their tithes and their offering. And you got your hand up. I got mine up. Okay, I'm going to do it on my phone, but I got it up. I got it up. We're sowing $100 above our tithes and our offering. I'm waiting on you. Because I know you're here. Thank you. Thank you, saints. Thank you, saints. Thank you, saints. You're shifting us over. Shifting us over. Things we got to do. Things we're trying to do. Things we're going to accomplish. Things we're doing. Talking to Minister Devin. We're talking about the RAC committee of the team and what we want to do and random acts of kindness. And as I said, I'm not asking the governor. I'm fighting through all these rants. We're blessed in this house. We got this. We need to take backpacks out to them. We need to take sleeping bags out to them. They need stuff. We need tennis shoes. They need stuff. That's real. And so I've included. I ain't going to let the devil make me wait on the building when God anointed us. We'll go to them.
Right.
We'll go to them. Amen. All right, everybody, you're paying your tithes and offerings. We're sowing. We're giving and honoring the Lord. Father, I thank you for everyone that is giving today. Father, I thank you for the blessing that you've placed on us. Lord, thank you for your word of honor. Thank you for destroying yokes. Thank you for removing the scalp from our eyes. But Father, we will never lie to you. We honor you. We will never cheat you. We honor you. And so, Lord, we recognize you have blessed us to be a blessing. So this seed that we're sowing, Father, we ask you to come back to us some 30, some 60, some 100-fold. Father, allow welcome to give it to our business that we will happen to give again. And we promise to give you and you alone all the glory, all the honor, and the praise, all the people of God said.
Amen.
Amen.